안녕하십니까. Nicolas 입니다. Before this video starts, just want to let you know that we just finished recording, subtitling, and uploading a 5-hour free React Native for Beginners course. So if you want to know how to make iOS and Android applications using React.js and JavaScript, then please check out the link on the description. It's a free React Native for Beginners course, 5 hours for free on the link. See you there. On today's video, we're going to learn how to design beautiful and easy to use REST APIs. There will be a time in your developer career where you will need to make a REST API. So it's very important to design it well from the beginning so our users or our team members have an easier time learning it and using it. For this video, let's pretend that we're going to make a movies API that needs to support the basic CRUD operations. CRUD means create, read, update, and delete. Now this means that our users should be able to add movies, search for movies, see the actors of a movie, delete movies, etc. So let's get started. Our first impulse would be to just make a URL for every action that the API needs to support. Now if we do this, our API might look something like this. Now, as you can see, this design does not look good. Our users or our team members will have a hard time understanding and learning this API because there is no clear pattern. As you can see, sometimes we use the word add, sometimes we use the word create, sometimes we use edit, sometimes we use update. That is not good. There has to be some standard. So what we can do to improve this is, number one, drop the verbs from the URL. This means remove all the words that say add or edit or delete from the URLs completely. Now, as you can see, without the verbs on the URLs, all we have now is just nouns. We have movie, movies, and inception. In this case, we're going to use two things. Number one, the name of something called the collection, which is basically movies. So we're going to use the plural. And also, we're going to be using the word inception, which is sort of the unique identifier of an object on the database. Now, this leaves us with only two URLs. We have slash movies, and we have slash movies slash inception. Now, instead of using verbs in the URL, like add, delete, create, whatever, we're going to use HTTP methods to interact with the resources. HTTP methods are, for example, get, post, put, and delete. We're going to use get to read something. We're going to use post to create something. We're going to use put to update something and delete to delete something. Using HTTP methods combined with the nouns in our URLs, that means that, for example, a get request to the slash movies URL should give me all the movies. A post request to the slash movies URL should create a movie. As you can see, it's the same URL, but it's a different method. We won't support delete or update methods for slash movies because we don't want to delete or update all the movies at once. So instead, we're going to be using the name of the collection, which is slash movies, plus the identifier of the resource, which is slash inception, and we're going to combine them with the HTTP methods again. In this case now, a get request to slash movies slash inception will show me the details of the movie inception. And if I want to edit or if I want to delete the movie, all I have to do is change the method to put or to delete without changing the URL. As you can see, we just made a CRUD API only with using two URLs. This is so much better than what we had before. Now, if you want to, we can also use URLs to interact with relationships between objects. So for example, if I want to see the actors of the movie Inception, I could do a get request to slash movies slash Inception slash actor. And if I want to maybe connect an actor to the movie Inception, or I want to delete an actor from the movie Inception, I just have to do put or delete. Again, as you can see, this is way better than what we had before, and it's more intuitive. The people using this API will have an easier time understanding why we made the decision that we made. To handle search or filtering of movies, for example, there is no need to make URLs like, for example, slash get top rated movies or slash find movies released this year. That is not good. Instead, what we can do is we can use the query parameters. So we could have a URL like this one or this one. But as you can see, this is way better than having to create one new URL for every sort of search that we would like to perform. Or you can create a more specific slash search URL if you want to. Also, using query parameters, you can add pagination to your API doing something like this. And that's it for this video. As you can see, we went from having something very ugly and confusing to an API that people will be able to understand, people will be able to remember, people will be able to learn, and it will be a pleasure to work with. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any tips, suggestions on how to make our API design better, then please leave them on the comment. If you like what you see, leave a like and subscribe to the channel. And also, don't forget, if you want to learn React Native, then go and join our free 5-hour React Native for Beginners course. See you on the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Be happy today. Eat kimchi. Hamsamida. Saranghaeyo. See you. Bye-bye.